Toy sales have always been an important part of Star Wars. George Lucas even basically said that if he was going to make any money out of Star Wars, it would be off of the toy sales. But generally when you think of this, you think of the kind of movie tie-in toys, and the occasional broader part or more important part of the expanded universe that gets turned into a specific toy. But today we're going to be looking past the Black Series action figures or any of the other higher profile action figures or Lego and going to a toy line that has some of the most obscure parts of Legends and even new canon in their toy lines and has for decades, including some ships that really are best depicted by these toys because of just how rare they are in the universe. These are the Micro Machines, and this is something that applies not just to Star Wars, but other universes like Star Trek and Babylon 5, where a lot of stuff that's really obscure gets turned into a toy. You of course have your standard X-Wings and TIE Fighters, Star Destroyers, the Executor, and all that kind of stuff that you'd expect, but on top of that you have some really deep cuts in which ships and vehicles or even planetary features get turned into a toy. Because a lot of these have been made for so long, it is a bit difficult to find a whole list of what's out there, but just by looking around at some different sites I was able to find a lot of ships that you really don't see anywhere else. One of the biggest ones in this category is the Tsuruvi Shree-class battlecruiser, which is from the Trusabakura book. This is one of the only appearances we get of a, or one of the only depictions we get of a Tsuruvi ship outside of just non-color illustrations. So this is actually the only source we technically have for what color Tsuruvi ships would be. Novel-wise, well, the Shree does get mentioned in New Jedi Order, I believe. It only appears in the Trusabakura, so it's really a one-and-done kind of thing, and yet there's a toy of it. There's toys for other obscure stuff, like the Scimitar Assault Bomber, Guri's Stinger, the Aggressor Fighter, Star Vipers. Basically, a lot of names that might not even be familiar to pretty hardcore Star Wars fans who are relatively familiar with a lot of the Expanded Universe source material. Unfortunately, the picture quality that I'm going to be able to have for this video is not great because there's only so many images of a lot of these that actually exist out there. There's just so many things, and there doesn't seem to be a central repository of any listings for all this, except for some of the ones that are on sale still, because a lot of these are still made for new canon, especially, where there's some stuff from, like, The Mandalorian that gets turned into toys. I was even able to find one picture that seemed to include the Azur Angel, which is Anakin's starfighter in the Clone Wars cartoon, the original one. Kind of a listing for an auction that had already finished, so it's a bit hard to track down a lot of these right now, even just pictures of them. One of the weirdest to me has to be the Tafonda Bay. This is an Ithorian herd ship, which is a type of ship that orbited the Ithorians' planet, Ithor, because they were not able to go down to the surface. It was basically sacred to them. So all the Ithorians lived in these herd ships above the planets. And it's something that doesn't show up in a ton of places. It does get referenced a fair bit, but it's really not something that I would ever expect to be made into a toy. I've personally never been someone who's collected a lot of Star Wars memorabilia, aside from stuff like books and RPG guides, so it's not something that I've ever owned. I've never had any of these Micro Machines myself, but just from like a pure lore side, it's kind of interesting to me just how many of these are out there and all the different types of ships that they encapsulate. Either way, I just wanted to make a quick video about it because it's something that I think is really cool, but also kind of weird. Hope you guys have enjoyed. If there is a topic you'd like to see me cover on the channel, please leave in the comments. And if you've enjoyed the video, consider leaving a like or subscribing for more. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.